Microlecture 11, The African Slave Trade. In this lecture, we will discuss slavery's role in African societies before the Europeans' arrival in the 16th and 17th centuries. Before the Europeans' intrusion, the exchange of people capturing local and ethnic wars within the sub-Saharan Africa was common. The trans-Saharan slave trade with the Mediterranean Islamic world and the slave traffic across the Indian Ocean all testify to the long tradition and continental dimensions of that trade in the region. However, we should be absolutely clear about the fact that this practice was not associated with any kind of racial connotation and indeed was common not only in Africa but all over the world since ancient times. Sanctioned by law and custom, enslaved people served critical and well-defined roles in the social, political, and economic organization of many African societies. Domestically, these roles range from concubines and servants to royal guards and advisors. As it happens in the Americas, some enslaved people were common laborers. In economic terms, slaves were commodities for trade, no more or less important than other trade items such as gold and ivory. Islamic practices strongly influence African slavery. African rulers justify enslavement with the Muslim argument that prisoners of war could be sold and that captured people were considered chattel, or personal possessions, to be used any way their owner wanted. Between 650 and 1600 CE, Muslims transport black slaves across the Trans-Saharan trade route. In the 14th and 15th centuries, the ruling elites in Mali and Benin import thousands of white Slavic enslaved people as symbols of wealth and status. These people had been captured by Turks, Mongols, and others in the Balkans and the Caucasus. Black people began moving from Africa to Europe during the Renaissance. This movement of people continued during the early modern period. It is believed that during the 17th and early 18th centuries, more than 200,000 Africans entered European societies. Some arrived as slaves, others as free people. However, we don't know much about the actual legal distinction established between the two at the time. For example, in London, the black population constituted a well-organized self-conscious subculture with black pubs, black churches, and black social groups assisting the black poor and unemployed. Some black people had considerable wealth and a good social position. In 1658, the Dutch East India Company began to import enslaved people to its colony in the Cape of Good Hope. Over the next century and a half, the Dutch brought to Africa people from India, Southeast Asia, and Madagascar. These enslaved subjects were employed on public works and company farms. By 1780, half of the white men at the Cape had at least one slave. Although in the 17th and 18th centuries Holland had a Europe-wide reputation for religious tolerance and intellectual freedom, in its colonies the Dutch used a strict racial hierarchy and heavy-handed paternalism to control enslaved natives and foreign-born peoples. The slave trade expanded greatly in Africa in the late 18th century and the first half of the 19th. Merchants and planters with business there wanted slaves to work the sugar, cloves, and food plantations in places like Mascaran Islands, Madagascar, Zanzibar, and Pemba. The institution of slavery existed in Africa before the arrival of the Europeans. However, only after the first wave of European colonialism, it became a system of racial stratification and exploitation. The impact of the system can still be felt today in many places on the African continent. This is all we have for today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.